Now we can move on to the one of the bacterial infection of the skin, that is impetigo. So impetigo is relatively common contagious superficial skin infection caused by either Staphylococcus aureus or beta hemolytic streptococci, and it is a superficial epidermal layers. Only the superficial epidermal layers will be affected. Highly contagious means highly infective. Okay, it will be transferred from one person to another, and it's commonly occur in children. And impetigo is mainly divided in two forms: non-bullous impetigo and bullous impetigo. The main risk factors for impetigo is hot and humid weather, crowded living conditions, poor hygiene, immunosuppression, the nasal carriage of Staphylococcus aureus. That is an important factor for the recurrent infections. Now we can move on to the characteristics, clinical features of non-bullous impetigo or the impetigo contagiosa. So usually this impetigo contagiosa, it begins as a small reddish macule which soon turns into vesicle or vesiculopustule. So macule, vesicle, we already studied, and vesiculopustule means the vesicle that contains pustule. The vesicle has a thin roof that ruptures to expose a red moist base. So usually when if there is vesicle, the outer covering will be very thin and it will ruptures. Then what happens? The serous and purulent fluid dries to form a reddish brown or honey colored firmly adherent crust. So we already studied regarding the crust, right? So in the crust, we have studied yellow colored crust and the brownish appeared crust. Okay, so when the serous fluid is escaped or purulent fluid is escaped, that forms the crust formation. The crust may thicken and has a stuck cone appearance as a hallmark of impetigo. That is the impetigo contagiosa. The hallmark is stuck appearance of this crust. When we are trying to remove this crust, there will be a slight erosion of our skin. Okay, the skin will be peel off while removing the crust. So it appear as a reddish appearance again. Then the satellite lesions may appear in the vicinity, resulting in annular gyrate patterns. Annular means ring shaped patterns. Okay, it can be occur. The lesions may be in ring shaped patterns or gyrate pattern. Gyrate patterns means S shaped patterns. Okay. And face, hands, feet, legs are the usual sites of involvement. However, the lesion may appear anywhere on the body. Most lesions will heal without any scarring or other problems. Okay, so that is the feature of impetigo contagiosa or the non-bullous impetigo. Now we can move on to the bullous impetigo. So here there will be a small erythematous macule will be first, that turns into vesicle. Okay, however, the developing vesicles do not rupture but enlarge to form flaccid bulli. Okay, in impetigo contagiosa or non-bullous impetigo, we have studied that this vesicle that will ruptures and form crust. But here, bullous impetigo, these vesicles will not rupture.
and this vesicle what leads to flaccid bulle. The contents of the bulle initially clear, then turns to cloudy. Okay, the center of the thin roofed bulle collapses and collecting the seropurulent contents into falls. Eventually, the roof desiccates to form a thin honey-colored or varnish-like crust. Removal of this crust reveals an inflamed erythematous base that oozes serum. Okay, usually when the roof, that is when the bulle is collapsed, the collecting seropurulent contents that will be form a varnish like crust. Okay, so removal of this crust that will leads to the erythematous base, and that erythematous bases will be oozes out. That means there will be fluid will be leaking through this lesion, and if it is untreated, it leads to the problems like delayed wound healing problems and may occur scar. Okay, and it will be healed within few weeks.
Diagnosis of impetigo, that is usually done by looking the clinical features. Okay, we already explained there is different types of impetigo, round bullous impetigo and the bullous impetigo. Okay, so based on these features, the doctors easily can identify the impetigo. And some other methods we are used as a diagnostic measure is culture. Okay. And it will be done very rarely, and in order to identify the bacteria. I already explained Staphylococcus aureus and Streptococci may cause the impetigo. So, in order to identify the organism, we can do the culture. Okay, and the complete blood count usually check in the case of impetigo, because there is a chance of leukocytosis. Leukocytosis means WBC count will be increased. So, in order to identify that, we will do the complete blood count. Okay. Regarding the treatment, actually, as a general measure, we can use the soap and water to remove the bacteria and to clean the crust. Okay. And saline solutions and boric acid, aluminium acetate, potassium permanganate, that also useful for the cleaning. Okay, cleaning of the crust. Okay, these all are the general measures can be used. That is, boric acid can be used, aluminium acetate can be used, and potassium permanganate can be used to cleanse the area, or impetigo site can be cleansed by these solutions. And in the activity, there is no restrictions for the activity for the patient. And hygiene is important. Okay, for the patient, hygiene is important. So, you can give the educations like the regarding maintenance of personal hygiene. Okay, and actually the treatment in a simple impetigo, it may cure without any medications. Okay, but in serious cases or bullous impetigo, it needs treatment. Okay, so usually we can give dicloxacillin, cefalexin, erythromycin, clindamycin, amoxicillin and clavulanic acid or clavulanate, amoxicillin, mupirocin ointment. Mupirocin ointment, that is for the topical applications. Okay, so the patient needs sometimes the oral medication, oral antibiotic treatment. So, based on sensitivity, we can give the medicines. Okay, we will not give all the medicines. We can give these medicines, and based on the patient response, we will give the antibiotics. Okay, and in case of methicillin-resistant Staphylococcus aureus, we will say MRSA, methicillin resistant staphylococcus aureus. So that time only we can give the minocycline ciprofloxacin tablets. Okay, so in the treatment you just understand we can give the amoxicillin penicillin group of drugs. Okay, then the cephalexin, that is the cephalosporin third generation group. Okay, just understand we can give the penicillin group of drugs and you can study some names like cephalexin, erythromycin, amoxicillin. Okay, you will study later regarding the pharmacology. That time you will knew better than this time. Now you study the name only. Okay.